Greetings, Earthlings! Today I'm back with a review of another XLR condenser microphone. So today we're reviewing this guy, which is the Neat King B XLR condenser microphone, which costs around $100. Like always, I'll throw some links down below. And for this review, I have the microphone connected directly to my 18i 22nd Gen. The gain is set at around 12 o'clock. I will not do any kind of post-processing, but I may have to boost the audio in post, so check the doobly-doo to see what I diddly did. Now let's talk about what comes in the box. Of course, you are going to get the microphone. You'll get a shock mount, which does come with a 5/8 to 3/8 inch microphone stand adapter, two additional screws to mount this to the shock mount, a pop filter, a felt storage bag or dust cover, some documentation, and another one of those really weird spinning tops that correlates to the Neat microphone you have. I don't know. Then, as far as the build quality, the microphone feels extremely well put together. It has an all-metal body with these yellow rubber bands all the way around it. The grill is all metal, but it does have a little bit of give to it. It weighs in at 785 grams, so it is on the heavier side. As you move around the microphone, there are no switches or anything. It is a very basic microphone, and on the bottom, you will find the XLR port. Then, as far as the specs, this microphone has a cardioid polar pattern, a frequency response of 16 Hz to 20 kHz, a sensitivity of around negative 32 decibels, a max SPL of 140 dB, a self-noise of only 6.5 dBA, and an impedance of 150 ohms. Now I am spinning around the Neat King B to 90 degrees to show you what the off-axis rejection and coloration is. We'll continue around the microphone to 180 degrees. Here's how it sounds from the rear. Continuing around to the second 90 degree angle, and then we will rotate and end at the front of the microphone. And now let's go ahead and test the plosive rejection of the provided pop filter. Please bring pizza pronto. Please bring pizza pronto. Please bring pizza pronto. Please bring pizza pronto. Now I want to see if the provided pop filter affects the tone of the microphone at all. So right now I am speaking into the King B without the pop filter attached, and here is how the audio sounds. And now I am speaking into the microphone with the provided pop filter attached, and here is how the microphone sounds. Now I am right on top of the microphone to show you the proximity effect on this thing. About 3 inches off of the mic with it pointed at the corner of my mouth, and here is how it sounds. 1 foot away from the microphone, 2 feet away from the microphone, and about 4 feet away from the Neat King B. Now I am typing on a keyboard with Cherry MX Blues to see how much of my voice versus how much of the keyboard it picks up. And for you sad W gamers, now I am typing on the Leet keys. Now, in order to test how well the provided shock mount works, I am bumping my desk to see how much of that noise it rejects. And I will tap on the boom arm to see how much of that the microphone picks up. Now I'm speaking into the microphone in a well-treated room, and here is how it sounds. And here is how the microphone sounds in a completely untreated room. Now I want to do a very quick comparison to another $100 condenser microphone, the Audio-Technica AT2020. So right now I am speaking into the Neat King B about 3 inches off of the microphone with my gain set at 12 o'clock on the 18i20. And here is how the audio is sounding. And now I am speaking into the AT2020 at the exact same distance with the exact same gain setting, and here is how the audio sounds. Let me know in the comments down below, which do you prefer the sound of, the AT2020 or the King B? happiest new year. All I have is thanks to you out there. So may I ask you a favor, please? Won't you have the best 2020 you'd believe? From the bottom of my heart, it sounds so cheesy. Thank you for an amazing 2019. It was an incredible year, and I could not have done it without you. So happy new year, and I hope 2020 brings you everything that you want, and best of luck to you. All right. So if you're looking for a starting microphone and your budget is around $100, I honestly think that this microphone is a no-brainer. And first up, in terms of pros, the price. It is a relatively affordable microphone that sounds surprisingly good for $100, and I believe that it started at a $300 price point, but since Neat is now an independent company, they have more control over their pricing, and at $100, I think it's an insane deal. It also has a nice top-end boost to add some detail and clarity, but it doesn't get overly harsh or shrill. It also has a nice and full low end, which can really help beefen up a recording, especially if you have a higher pitched voice like mine. But if you were to have a super bassy voice, it may not be the most flattering, and it may get a little bit too overpowering in the lower frequencies. Additionally, it did a good job at rejecting plosives, even when we didn't have the provided pop filter on the microphone, and I wasn't expecting this, but the shock mount did a tremendous job at rejecting the bumps of the desk as well as the bumps of the boom arm. And then in terms of cons, this may not really be a con for everybody, but the microphone is extremely heavy, so if you're using it on a cheaper boom arm, you need to be exceedingly careful because, as you saw, it might just tip over, and I guess that's less of a con and more of an FYI for you. And also, if you are a crazy person who focuses a lot on the looks of a microphone, in my opinion, you should buy a microphone based on the sound, not what it looks like. But if you are that crazy person, you may not like the look of this because it has a very unique, very bumblebee-looking aesthetic. Then as far as my overall thoughts on this microphone, on the electric guitar, I thought the top end was very smooth and crisp and detailed, but at no point did it become shrill or harsh or painful to listen to, and that really became apparent when the lead guitar came in and it went to the upper register. Those notes are typically very difficult to capture without becoming piercing, and on this microphone, that wasn't a thing. It also had a very full low end, and it might even be on the verge of being too full and too bassy, but that would be easily solvable by throwing on a high pass filter, which you're most likely going to do in a full mix anyways. Then on the acoustic guitar, I absolutely loved the top end of this microphone. It was just so articulate and shiny, and then the low end was punchy and tight and full without becoming boxy or boomy, and I just love this thing on the acoustic guitar. Then for singing, the main thing that stuck out to me was how airy this microphone sounds. It is very open, but at the same time, it adds this breathy quality to the recording. Some people will love that, some people will hate that, but I actually rather enjoyed it for that application. And lastly, for spoken word, I would describe it as having a very powerful low end, as well as a very crisp and detailed and articulate top end, although I would say it is, again, on the verge of being a little bit too crispy, not quite there, but it is almost there. But given it is a $100 microphone, when you compare it to some competition out there, the top end is incredible. And finally, would I recommend this microphone? Yes, completely. At $100, I am fairly certain that the AT2020 is the most popular microphone at that price point, but to my ears, this microphone just sounds better. When I did that very brief spoken word comparison between the AT2020 and the King Bee, the AT2020 just sounded top-heavy and metallic and all around unpleasant compared to this microphone. Now, don't get me wrong, this microphone does have a lot of top end to it due to the Presence treble and air boost, but the mids and the lower frequencies seem a little bit more balanced to my ears, which offsets that high boost and makes it more even sounding. So to summarize, on the electric guitar, the acoustic guitar, for singing, and for spoken word, I rather liked this microphone, and at the $100 price point, I think it's a pretty compelling option. Alright, and that is going to wrap up for today, so if you found this video fun, interesting, or helpful, go ahead and give me a thumbs up. If you hated it, give me a big ol' thumbs down. If you want to hang out in the Discord server, I'll go ahead and throw a link in the description. And if you want to support the channel and become one of these amazing people over here, you can do so by clicking that join button and joining at the $5 tier or higher. It really does help me continue to bring you these videos, and I appreciate you all so much. So until next time, thank you so much for watching. Thank you so much for listening. Bye.